In dividing fractions, such as 4 over 7 divided by 2 over 3, we first invert the second fraction, so it becomes 3 over 2. And then we perform multiplication. Multiply the numerators, so 4 times 3, which is 12, and then multiply the denominators, 7 times 2, which is 14. Our answer is 12 over 14, which can be reduced to 6 over 7, and that's the final answer. In this problem, we could have used cancellation. After we did the inversion, we look at the numerator of the first fraction and the denominator of the second fraction, and the numerator of the second fraction and the denominator of the first fraction. In comparing these numbers, if there's a common multiple, a number that can be divided evenly into both of the numbers, we can cancel or reduce. In this problem, the 4 and 2 have a common multiple of 2. So 2 goes into 4 two times, and 2 goes into 2 once. And we get the same answer as before, with less steps. Here are a couple more examples of dividing fractions, with the steps written out, inversions, and any cancellations. The other division problems you may come across involve mixed numbers, which have a whole number with a fraction. In order to divide these, you first need to convert the mixed numbers to improper fractions. That is, fractions that have numerators that are greater than or equal to the denominators. For instance, 6 divided by 2 and 1 over 3. First, we convert both the numbers, and we get 6 over 1 divided by 7 over 3. Then we invert the second fraction and perform multiplication, which gives us an answer of 18 over 7, which we can write as a mixed number of 2 and 4 over 7. Here are a couple more examples of dividing mixed numbers with the steps written out. All right, my friends, hopefully you got something out of this video. I do have more videos right there that you might have an interest in. Till next time, I am out of here.